Right. Hello, everyone. Hopefully, the balance between my voice and the game will all be much better than it has been in the past. Certainly, let me know in the chat if the audio levels are as bad as they were last time. I was definitely peaking out, so if you find that my volume is a little bit too loud on the voice and it's causing issues, please let me know. So I'm going to be playing the campaign here. I have not played the story mode in this game. This will be my Let's Play series for this game. I figured I would do it as a live stream. That way just post to my channel. For people who watch this, not only in the live stream, but people who also watch this after the fact, please give me feedback. Is this something you'd like to see me do more often? I don't know that I'm going to be nearly as entertaining as many of the main live streamers out there. I know that I do have some issues with internet connectivity because I have AT&T and they are the worst. But if this is the type of thing that you would like to see, please give me that feedback. Because I am definitely a video gamer and I play a lot of video games. I just don't do it a lot on my channel. And I have at least one other game I know that I definitely want to play on this channel. So please just let me know. Give me that feedback. As always, I will take a bit of time in my live streams to do something I don't normally do when I'm doing my videos, except for maybe the end, and that's just to always kind of promote. You know, please give me likes. If you want to do any fan funding, that is an option that I have enabled. And of course, I have a Patreon page if you would like to see more content there. The content that Patreon specifically supports does not include a lot of the videos that I do. My Patreon only supports the actual product reviews, sword reviews, etc. It supports my documentary series, Historia, and informational series that I may do, but those are kind of few and far between. So really, it's mainly those two. Like to already thank the 11 people that are already watching within the first 3 minutes. That's really awesome. It's amazing how quickly people are jumping on. Hello, everyone. We're gonna jump right into story mode here. We're gonna see how it goes. Chapter one is Knights, so I'll be going with that, I suppose. I feel like there should be a cutscene here. Is there not a cutscene? How do I know? No idea. Just kind of goes right into it. Difficulty realistic. No fight UI, fewer checkpoints. I think I'm going to go with hard difficulty. I don't like to go just with normal. I like to be challenged. So you're probably going to see me die a lot, is what this means.
The Wardens. Members of an ancient order. Fallen into dust. Sworn to defend the weak. Masters of the longsword. Their origins lost to history. Still they fight for what is right. But only a few may join their order.
All right, there we go. Looking at some of the things that people are saying. For honor, and yes, let's do this. What time is it in my country? It is 7:22 p.m. as of the time of me looking at the clock. I will try to answer some questions while playing, keeping in mind that it's really difficult to do both. So I'm going to do my best. All right. I've been playing a little bit of the multiplayer as I've not wanted to dive right into the campaign without doing a live stream. But now that I've gotten to that point, we're going to get right into it. Looks like my video quality is not doing real great. Have I seen Skull
that day I learned that I was serving the wrong warlord. Purvis Dobbly.
Defend the walls!
The day that I met the Blackstone Legion and Holden Cross.
Come out! Dominie! It doesn't have to be like this!
Keep them off the walls!
My lord.
Break it down!
Break it down!
But I am a warden.
Go! Get in there!
I had a job to do.
I need to get moving.
Alright, so one first I...
Blackstones were coming up the east wall.
Keep them off the
wall. In general, I will be quiet when cutscenes happen. Because when there's a cutscene happening, certainly you don't want some joker constantly talking. Why is it doing a tutorial again? It's kind of silly. You don't want some joker constantly talking over what everything you're trying to say, or what you're trying to watch, right? So I try to be quiet when there's a cutscene, so you can just enjoy what's happening on the screen. Okay. So apparently this is a tutorial level, because it's pushing me through things I've already done before. So I'll answer some questions. One person asked if I'd seen Skull of Gladiatoria's video on For Honor. I'll be honest, I did actually watch Skull of Gladiatoria's, because I think he was doing something at least a little bit different. A lot of my peers all did basically the same video series, which was, let's just talk about the historical accuracy of For Honor. A lot of it was speaking against the game theory video, and honestly, you know, I have no interest in doing those type of videos. It's cool if they want to. I don't really have an interest in those kind of videos. I find them very clickbait in a way, and I try not to do that in a lot of ways. I try to do videos that I would want to see, and honestly, I don't watch a lot of the clickbait style videos. I did watch Skull of Gladiatoria's video, because I was curious what he would have to say, if he would really add anything new. And in all honesty, he said absolutely nothing that was surprising to me. It's really quite simple. It's always been really quite simple. Vikings would not stand up against knights. Samurais, while they very skilled warriors, did not have the level of protection and armor they would need. It's moderately good, but also their weapons are not designed to fight something like the modern or
reinforcements were coming.
The contemporary knight
to hold that wall.
So it's one of those things where, you know, it's like you don't really need to hear someone say what's already been said a thousand times. But at the same time, I understand that is kind of the content that a lot of my peers like to do, and it's the type of content that a lot of people like to watch. I'm not going to knock that. It's fun to watch them tear apart some terrible YouTube video, and I'll definitely agree that can be a lot of fun. But I find it just kind of like, once one person said it, you don't need everyone to say it. And I think it was Metatron, Skalagrim, Shad, and Snapjelly, all of them did conversations about this. I was not going to add to that phrase, so I bowed out of that one. I wasn't going to be able to add anything new, and I wasn't really going to do that type of content anyway. So, you know, interesting topics, but nothing new coming from that.
The courtyard.
Let's see. Calling out Skull of Gladiatoria. Catch me at long point. How about that? I hope he's at long point again. That'd be great. What's my favorite of the warriors in For Honor? I do enjoy the warden. Mostly that just has to do with I like swords. And that's the one that you get to do swords. I'm really enjoying, I don't remember what the name of it is, the one that has a poleaxe. I think they're all actually fun to play, but it has more to do with the mechanics of the game than it does to do with individual classes right now. I'm sure that I'll find some that I really like more than others at some point. Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people have some very interesting videos to say on these things, especially For Honor. You know, historical accuracy of For Honor, who cares? It's a fantasy game. We're not really expecting it to be historically accurate. The developers of the game don't expect it to be historically accurate. Yeah, I view it as just a non-issue. It's not something that I'm really all that concerned with. In general, again, these conversations have happened a billion times. They will happen a billion more. It's like the whole katana versus longsword debate that has gone on for, I mean, just a decade at this point, easily. And no one's brought anything new to the table with that, really, in all this time. Yeah, I actually don't know if they all focused on different factions or not. I'll be honest, I did not watch the videos. As soon as I saw, like, everyone posting videos on the same topic, I was disinterested. I say this as I play a Let's Play that is... Everyone is doing a Let's Play this game, right? I mean, I'm doing a Let's Play because I'm enjoying the game. And I figure I might as well do a video of it. Maybe people would enjoy watching me play. I know I've enjoyed Let's Plays before. So I figure why not people enjoying what I do. Watch me play it, watch my commentary on it. In general, when it comes to video games and fantasy and all that, I'm really lenient. I don't really care about historical accuracy. It doesn't get me upset. I think Matt's video did a really good job. It's just, you know, he doesn't care. It doesn't matter. It doesn't change what happened in history, whether or not this is realistic or not. Because it's not going to be. And that's okay. It doesn't need to be. It's a video game. You know, freaking out about historical accuracy of this game is pointless. But I've been enjoying it. I think the gameplay is fairly good. It can get a little bit repetitive in some ways, so I'm looking to this campaign to actually give me something more interesting than just kind of repetitive, simple gameplay mechanics. I do like that the different classes have different features. The catapult's
still ready to fire.
There were trailers, not really trailers, but videos that showed about all this stuff already. A lot of the kind of preview videos for all of this segment. Someone asked me how my day was. The day's been really good. I try to always have good days.
Through the breach!
Despite being fantasy, For Honor is actually more realistic. I think they do nods to realism, right? I can't say it's purely realistic. Certainly it's a lot slower. The combat is a lot slower, right?
A battering ram would end this fight.
Sorry, I got busy trying to throw a guy into fire. You know, it's a lot slower than it should be, obviously. But I think that's okay. If it was as fast as it would be in real life, you wouldn't have time to react, so I'm okay with that.
Make them pay for every inch of ground!
Yeah. You know, MatPat game. I'm assuming MatPat is game theory. I'm pretty sure that's the same guy, but he's completely wrong. I don't really pay that much attention to it. Yes, but should it be a surprise to anyone that when someone is not a history expert talking about history, that they get things wrong? I don't know. Alright, I should be doing something else. I'm supposed to be going somewhere. Bolt the castle. I guess I'm supposed to just be fighting, because I figure there's another objective, but not. Okay, there we go.
Show yourself! These warriors don't have to die. Trial by combat, right now!
What? Fight you? That's not a trial. That's an execution.
Then fight my second.
I second.
All right, then. If I refused, there would be a slaughter.
Romeo Lopez, U.S. Air Force?
He was a warden too. Or had been. He's good. I needed to win, but not for Dominic.
Well, Romeo Lopez, thank you for your service, sir. I just want to say that, you know. If you were Air Force for a different nation, I'd still call you out and say, you know, what you do is amazing, and I give you a lot of credit for what you do. But, especially...
We were still at their mercy.
It will not do for a knight of the Blackstone Legion to be defeated by a common mercenary. Kneel. Valor in battle, for honor and service, I, Holden Cross, raise you. Stand, Knight of the Blackstone Legion. We're finished here. Come on.
That was how I joined the Blackstone Legion.
So I make people are making points in the chat that that obviously game theory has a big audience, and that's part of the reason people push back against it. And I completely agree with that sentiment. You're never really going to change the minds of a lot of people who aren't looking for the truth. That's true of a lot of things. I don't disagree that the videos countering it should be made.
That warden proved more than worthy. But there was still much work to be done. The Vikings were about to destroy the last Iron Legion sanctuary in Ashfeld. My Blackstone Legion would save them.
And someone made the mention that it's crazy that I'm playing the video game, paying attention to the chat. It's not as crazy as it may seem. I'm able to do both because there are moments that I can take a little bit of a breather and glance over. But I am actually pretty good at multitasking. It really annoys people. They think I'm not paying attention because I'm doing something else. And realistically, I know exactly what I'm doing. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, I actually find it very interesting that we don't see many kind of similar channels from other areas. And maybe it's because I'm only English speaking, so if I were to find a Russian channel that does something like what I do, I wouldn't know how to understand that's what they're doing. but
there are many legions. The Iron Legion is the greatest among them. But in Ashfeld, the Iron Legion was about to be routed. Their commander, Stone, needed an army. Holden Cross sent me.
Blackstone! Where are reinforcements?
I'm it.
Is this a joke?
Open the gate! Lead us out, Blackstone! Good luck!
The battle was already lost. I needed to change that.
There's been a lot of comments recently about how video games kind of over-tutorialize everything. I'm agreeing with that right now. They sent me through tutorials to the game, and now the campaign is doing the same thing. I don't know why that's necessary. You couldn't even start the game without doing the tutorial. You don't need all that. Alright, figure it out.
We needed to take back the flanks.
Alright, so I'm supposed to take back the flanks, which is this way.
I need to take that garrison.
Hey, Knight Squire, how's it going, sir?
Killing all the Vikings in this area will claim the garrison for us. I need to take the flanks. This place will help us gather reinforcements.
Okay, now I can use a catapult. That'll be fun. To show you guys what this looks like. Just take these guys out.
Archers need to go. We need to hold the key battlefield positions.
Good thing the catapult saw me pointing. Yes, well let's remember. The realism of this game is already in question, right? I was thinking the same thing.
This place will help us bring archers to the field.
call this suspension of disbelief. I like that one of the ways that you get healing is by killing
that garrison.
All these kind of eons. By doing massively spinny moves, just like that. Great. Why they feel like it's necessary to constantly redo the tutorial they just had me do.
Those archers need to go. We need to clear all the Vikings to claim this archer point. Final push.
Keep pushing. Sorry, I'm not talking a lot because I'm thinking. I'm trying to, I really don't know how live streamers who do this kind of on that semi-professional basis are able to talk while playing video games. It always amazes me. The fact I get so involved. Maybe it'd be easier if I had someone here that I was talking to, but I don't know. I find it amazing. That's all.
Get them someplace safe! Kill every last one!
Hey, alright, take his head off. Mordhows are really awesome. That's what it comes down to. I feel like I'm about to fight Eowyn here.
Push them out of the sanctuary!
Not bad, Blackstone. Not bad at all. Pretty sure I could have done it by myself, but
set a way to make the game, this game, 10,000% better set at Middle Earth. Shadow of Mordor is a really good game. Kind of does that. Honestly, War in the North was actually really good, but it went mostly unnoticed. good kind of hack and slash game. I'm kind of glad that there's this new IP out there. It's certainly fantasy, but I like.
We had the Vikings on the run.
It's new. It's
different. And in the mopping up efforts, we also claimed the rest of the scattered legions, bringing them under Blackstone rule. The Warden, I think, had reservations about some of our methods.
Sorry, Travis, I might have missed the first part of what you were talking about. These purpose points. Huh. Yes, Samurai Jack. Everyone should be excited for that. I'm actually going to move this up to realistic difficulty. I love Samurai Jack. It's such a good series. One of the best, in my opinion, one of the best cartoon series ever made. A lot of people don't like it because of the art style, but I think that's one of, like, the simplistic art style actually kind of works in its favor. If you go watch, kind of, not really documentaries, but behind the scenes making of things for that, you find out that they did that art style, which allowed them.
I had questions.
I'll get to that in a moment.
About the Blackstone Legion.
The last of the Vikings have holed up in an outpost up ahead. One that the Iron Legion deserted. Need backup?
I can handle it.
Careful with that ego.
Ready?
Lead the way.
Deserters? I wanted to see for myself. Stone was Iron Legion. I trusted him.
The simplistic animation in Samurai Jack enabled them to do higher number of frames per second for animation.
Something you want to talk about?
Not yet.
Pardon me. Most animations are actually done anywhere between 10 and 15 frames per second. So, give you an idea what that means. Most films record at 24 frames per second, and that results in some stuttering, right? It's intentional. It's a lot of what makes people happy with the way films play out. Makes them not motion sick, etc. Oh, goodness. But Samurai Jack, I think, was 30 frames a second, which is a standard for television, but that's live action, recorded television, not animation. See, really smooth animations, awesome fight scenes.
Doesn't look too hard.
Everywhere we go, we've abandoned our people. What has happened to the Iron Legion? Wait here. I'll clear the bridge.
Yeah, I won't disagree that it's a little bit disappointing this got pushed more into the realm of fantasy, but what are you going to do when you got kind of knights versus Vikings versus samurai? It's also really worth noting that if you really want good fantasy, hopefully... oh man, I just forgot the name. From the Warhorse Studio game. Sorry, too many things happening at once. Kingdom Come Deliverance. Deliverance Kingdom Come, whatever the title is.
It's time to remove the Viking threat.
Kingdom Come Deliverance, though, is... I played a little bit of it, and it's a lot more focused on trying to be historically accurate in terms of combat and all that. So I won't disagree in the concept... Oh, look, spike walls. I'm going to use that.
bastard! You could lead to them, man!
Yes, I know this already. You taught me this already. There needs to be a way to turn that off. There we go. Spike walls. Fun. But yeah, what it really comes down to, in my opinion, is video games will never really be able to be super realistic. It's kind of by their nature. They're unable to do that.
I need to defeat their commander.
How do you get up there? Heal myself a bit. The one thing I don't like about this game, in all honesty, is the pitfalls that you can do just by doing this kind of kick move. It seems like it's honestly a little bit too cheap. Like that right there, it's too easy in some ways. I'm not even trying to kill them that way, and I've just killed them all on the spike wall. I don't like the idea of easy, cheap kills. I've never really liked that in things like video games, and it doesn't make me any happier when it happens in a game like this. I was trying to target this guy, he's just a peon. Kill him. I actually like not having the notifications on the screen. Here's why. We'll do a video on this. So I'm really not paying attention to the chat right now, so probably a lot of questions have gone by. In playing this game, one of my biggest challenges has actually been watching what's going on and the notifications on the screen not matching up with what I'm seeing. And I have a certain desire to react a certain way that I really probably shouldn't. And most of that is tied to... That's my own guy. Most of that is tied to... maybe a little bit of my experience doing things like Longsword, and knowing how to read what people's actions are going to be. And, you know, even with a game that's highly unrealistic, you have a certain kind of response you want to have to the way a person postures. And so not having the indications is actually in some ways helpful, because I feel like I can read it slightly better. I don't know. I feel like I'm not distracted by it. These guys are tough. They move really quickly. Yeah, there was a Kickstarter for a historically accurate combat game. It was called Clang. I backed it. It was Neil Stephenson, and he screwed everyone with it. Still have the t-shirt, though. If anyone is interested, maybe I'll do a demo of what they did release with that game. They did actually have some content they got from it. And it was very janky and not really well polished, and that was where they left it. And it was really unfortunate, because it was a grand idea, but they didn't ever execute on it, which was really disappointing. Yeah, I'd really like to... There we go. The lock-on in this game is a little strange. Yeah. Real life nice to not have spike balls around.
custodiam! Duriter ostem ferite!
Yeah, it's definitely the issue with Kickstarter.
I want to talk to some of these deserters.
You really have to go in knowing that that's what's going to be a likely outcome of your investment, is that there's going to be nothing for it. If you're willing to do that, great. I kickstarted the Oculus Rift, and it paid off, right? It's just a matter of whether or not, you know, it'll actually pan out.
Members of the Iron Legion. All legions share the same oaths. What had happened here? Why have you abandoned your posts?
A Blackstone dog has strayed from his pack.
Stand down! Your people need you.
What's a warden doing fighting for Apollyon?
One of us should go home and change.
Why have you abandoned your posts?
Kill them.
We are going to have to fight on that. Day, I finally met our warlord.
Got your Blackstone. Do you know what kind of creature waits for its own slaughter? Sheep. Sheep.
No.
Welcome to the Blackstone Beach.
I had my answers, but too late. And a warden's oaths are not lightly broken.
I have to go rewatch it, but there was actually a halfway decent looking dagger disarm there. That was pretty interesting. One thing I don't like already about this game, and this is one of those realism things, there's no reason for them to put their swords in a sheath if they don't have a sheath. They might as well just not even do the animation. It makes no sense. It's a minor thing, but it's jarring when you watch that happen. So I'm going to complain about that. People were talking about microtransactions.
The time came to show the Vikings who they really were. We would strike deep into the heart of their lands. But first, we needed to cross the mountain pass. And Holden Cross would lead the charge.
Sorry. Try not to talk during these cutscenes. Yes, I'm playing on the realism setting, and speaking of microtransactions, I don't like microtransactions on a game that you pay $60 for. It does not matter, in my opinion, that it's just considered cosmetic or anything like that. The way microtransactions should work is free-to-play games, if those exist, they give you the game in its entirety, and you pay for those premium things because you're playing for free. When I pay $60 for a game, or in this case, I even paid even more because I got the special edition of it, I kind of don't want to have to go and then pay extra money. It's bleeding gamers dry, and honestly, they should be delivering it as part of the core gameplay package.
Where so. Order has broken down. Where cruelty and lawlessness rule. Lawbringers are justice. We go wherever we are needed, and we come prepared. Our armor has no equal. Its construction, a secret of our order. Pray that you do not need us. And when we arrive, pray that you have done no.
Cool. Lawbringer, that's fun. So, this is a class I couldn't remember the name of. I like the Lawbringer class because it's the closest thing to what a real medieval knight would have kind of looked like fighting on foot. You get to have the pole arm, you get to have the pole axe. And yes, responding to the comments here, yes, if you can earn those microtransactions or you can earn those things through gameplay, fine. At that point, fine, but don't ever block things behind a paywall.
The snow is already falling on Valkenheim. But we went anyway. I am Holden Cross. As commander of the Blackstone Vanguard, it fell to me to lead the way.
I get to have the Judge Judy and Executioner move.
Ambushed. Exactly what we have been hoping for.
For the Legion!
Roast delay!
I
need to get up there.
They're retreating!
For Ashfield! They know we're here! Keep moving! Have no fear! Protect the column!
Guys, sorry if my camera work is terrible during this segment. I can already feel that, like, it would make people motion sick watching this thing, I'm sure.
We are strong!
The entrance to Valkenheim.
There's still gonna be some floor notes on this stuff.
Out of my
ridiculous.
Way.
Right.
Savages. Those catapults needed to be shut down.
So, I will admit that, there are not, in my opinion, enough medieval games that are AAA titles. I really think Assassin's Creed is the only one the closest you could get. This game is certainly a lot better, in my opinion, at least for now. I wish there were
it
more good AAA
good
title
plan.
Games.
It was just my only option.
That were fantasy. We got Shadow of Mordor and all that, and that was kind of wonderful. So I'm actually getting a real kick out of just watching a lot of these cutscenes and action sequences. I think they're a lot of fun to watch. A lot of fun to see what's going on. What am I supposed to do with this? It's kind of a thing.
The Cataclysm.
Oh, interesting. Okay. I must have been missing those this entire time.
I need to take out that catapult.
Maybe I'll get this way later, but certainly the difficulty on this game is, even on this higher level, is not super difficult. Which is surprising, because I'm pretty bad at this game in the beta.
Time to shut down those catapults.
Try that.
I'll give this to the Viking. They're big.
Trying to do something.
I am Holden Cross.
Oh, all the way at the beginning.
As commander of the Blackstone Vanguard, it fell to me to lead the way. Ambushed. Exactly what we have been hoping for.
Guess that's maybe the big thing on the bigger, on the higher difficulty levels, is that there is no,
They know we're here! Keep moving!
There's no checkpoints like you would expect.
Be brave!
I don't know that I would have lost to that guy if it hadn't been. I was trying to do something very specific that I probably shouldn't have been trying to do at that exact moment. But, learned my lesson. Probably should have been trying to block his attacks, is what I should have been trying to do. I'll go ahead and quickly move forward here.
Do not fear them!
The entrance to Valkenheim.
Okay. Wow, I just died because I was trying to do something again. This, now I'm beginning to see the difficulty. As soon as she starts going downhill, it's very quick.
I am Holden Cross.
Well, you guys are going to get to see me repeat
as
this
commander
a lot.
Of the Blackstone Vanguard, it fell to me to lead the way. Ambushed. Exactly what we have been hoping for.
So many of my people fear the decorations of our savage foes. But I have never feared the demons of my enemies. I am their demon.
For the Legion! They know we're here! Keep moving!
Ambush! Knight just walking through the all that mayhem.
Entrance to Valkenheim.
I can't do this, so I'd be better here.
Out of my way.
Look at this villain they call in the catapult. Destroy things from a distance a bit.
Savages.
Those catapults needed to be shut down.
Who dares in our shop?
It's cold.
It wasn't a good plan. It was just my only option.
I need to take out that catapult.
Okay, I will take a moment to adjust the audio shortly here. Again, some people are saying it's harder to hear me. The game audio feedback. Yeah, I do actually plan on trying to make this a little bit more regular thing in video games on my channel. I'm a little bit worried about flooding my primary channel with this type of content because it may not be what people actually want to see in general for my channel. But at the same time, it's something I enjoy doing, and it's called YouTube for a reason, so... Let's see, where am I going here? This way. Into the water. This is terrible. That might make me change the difficulty back just so I can have checkpoints.
I'm holding cross.
That's a little bit disappointing. Let me actually change my audio settings real quick. Get myself a little bit more in the mic. Alright, hopefully this is a bit better.
As commander of the Blackstone Vanguard,
I'm gonna give it this one last try.
Me to lead the way.
Hang on, sorry. There we go. Getting shot with arrows because I didn't pause.
Ambushed.
If I fail here, I'll probably call the live stream a quit at that point, just so I can not have like a 3-hour live stream going on here, but I will of course pick up later.
Here.
I just fell off. That's not good. Let's try this again.
Clear his heart.
Just hack away at a guy for a while.
Open it. I need to get up there.
I think the reason that this feels difficult is not because the combat is difficult, but because if you make a bad mistake at some point, it will cost you all your progress in that level, which I think is interesting and extreme. Oh,
entrance to Valkenheim.
Out of my way.
Skip over that.
Those catapults needed to be shut down.
I have considered Twitch. I don't know if I'm going to do Twitch or not. I'm going to definitely start here if I decide to move over to Twitch.
It was just my only option.
I will make an announcement so people know to look there. That way I could actually get this off my primary channel, which might be beneficial for many viewers who may not really care to see this. I don't know. I'm looking for a lot of feedback on that. If people prefer Twitch, I would do that.
I need to take out that catapult.
Okay, I don't know what that was. I thought it was a catapult, but it was not. It was like some sort of explosive bomb thing. Yeah, I understand some people may not mind seeing it. Even if they're not going to watch it, they'd see it in their sub box. But I've actually had people complain before that I have videos that they don't want me to post. It happens when I do like kind of interviews and series where I go, oh, this isn't your main stuff. All I really care about is your main stuff. I try to take it into consideration. And then my viewers might actually only really watch my stuff because they're watching it for like sword reviews or not.
Give this to the Vikings.
Unexpected. All right. Well, I think that'll be it for the live stream this time around. That surprised me a bit. I don't know what happened there. I was trying to lock on and I couldn't. But anyway, we'll pick back up here next time I do the live stream. I'll probably play a little bit kind of periodically day in and day out. Sometimes, I think Saturday, I'm actually going to try to play for a longer period of time than just a little over an hour. And I'm going to look into what it might take to do like a Twitch account and all of that. But for the most part, this is For Honor. This is the campaign so far. I think it's a good bit of fun. I look forward to playing more of it. So, all right, everyone. Have a good one. Have a good night. Or if you're in other parts of the world, have a good morning or good day. Talk to you all later.